I'm going to be showing you what a very, very insecure PHP website can look at. So let's go to our admin login. And let's just try some SQL injection. Like, most people are checking for this now, so probably won't work. They use they sanitize their user inputs, so it's most likely won't. Let's log in. Okay, must have an at sign. Didn't work there. Let's just see, like, I'm just curious. I think if I put in a fake email like that, it might work. Let's try it. Okay. Holy shit. Well, it did work. And I'm surprised. Like, that hardly ever works. Because most people are sanitizing their user inputs for about the past 10, 20 years, so. But anyways, let's try the login. And let's just do the same thing. It worked for the user one too, so I can only see. Or if I know some SQL injection, eh? Log out again. And I just want to show you this code. Thank you. See? I'm on the unsecure branch. And let's go up. So here's where I connect. This is my database information. Then this is the post, the email, and the password that come from it, the form, in the form of a post. This is the user lookup. Let's do a query, put in my connection, type in the SQL here, and just put that PHP right in, or those two variables right into the SQL strings. That's why it was able to work. I was able to inject my own SQL code, and then I just get the data from it and set it all there. So that's how it is when it is bad. Now I'm just gonna quickly change over, say admin login, try that again. Now the hacker's just all upset. But let's just try the regular one. And there we go. Now I do want to show something. It's using plain text passwords here, which is horrible as well. Don't worry, we'll fix that in the next video. And I would never, deploy this website with plain text passwords, because that's just horrible security. Yep. Okay. Let's do the same. Login. Didn't work. Okay, let's use user one's login stuff. And you can only see this if you have user credentials. And that is actually true now. That's good. Let's go back here. I'll just quickly show you what changed. So I still have my connection information here. I use mysqli as the constructor. Let's go down here. So we still have our post variables there. Then instead of just using that query that I had before, I do connection, prepare, and then I give it the query with these two question marks that represent where the variables go. And then I go, okay, I'm going to bind those two question marks. I'm telling PHP here that those two question marks, I want these variables put in, but I want you to check them first to make sure nobody's trying to do something funky to me. And I say that there are also two strings. That's what that means. And then I go, okay, execute that query. Then take that result, bind it to the variable named email. And then I just go here while user lookup fetch. And then the reason why I have to do a while loop there is because there could be multiple users or multiple results. So it will run through them all. Now there should only be one in this case, but that's usually how you set it up. And yeah, I set the name, the email that was found, applied to true, and then send them to the privileged information right there. But anyways, that is how you can use prepared statements to protect against SQL injection. And in my next video, I will show you an even more secure PHP website that uses hashed passwords instead of plain text passwords. But regardless, I would recommend anybody who has a custom PHP website or a PHP website they made themselves, or anybody who has any website that was made, regardless of technology, they should try to log in with the credentials that I just was able to log into before. That quotation mark or quotation mark 1=1, and then just see if you can get in by using that type of method. Because that, if you can, you're vulnerable to SQL injection. And in this case, it was just very vulnerable to SQL injection. There was no checking going on. So I would highly recommend people with custom websites to try that. But thank you, and stay tuned for my next video.